Hey guys, this is David Kwan, and hello Blunty. So my name is David Kwan, and I'm responding to your video that you made, which is titled Xbox One, XBONE Nerd Rage. And I understand this is a response video to all the reactions and the comments you got on your video about Xbox One reveal. So this is just kind of you just responding to the nerd rage or the internet rage of your Xbox One reveal video, which I understand. But I also, and I have to say, before I talk about anything else, I do want to establish that I'm actually a huge fan of you, Blunty. I love your videos, and I think you are, you're funny, and I think you make really informative videos. I especially enjoy the one about Xbox One reveal, because it does give a new perspective. I mean, you're in Australia, so that always has a different perspective than a lot of people who do YouTube videos who live in America, or in UK, or whatever. So I do like the unique perspective you bring. So with that established, let me actually just share my thoughts on your video there that you uploaded today. I have to say, you know, by creating this video, you know, the thing is, I think you just created a vicious storm, or you just started fanning the flames of one. Because as you've said, the internet culture is one that reacts instantly and spontaneously. And a lot of people that watch your first video on Xbox One reveal, I agree. Most people probably just watched the first part of the video and then just didn't watch it at all. And that, I understand, as a YouTuber, as a video maker, that is kind of disappointing and that's frustrating. I mean, that's something I pretty much encounter all the time. People just read the title of my video and then comment based on the title, regardless of what I actually said in the video. That happens. And most people by this point, I'm 2 minutes into this video, most people have already dropped out by this point. They saw me talking, they saw my face, and they're like, oh, this is not what I clicked on to see, and they leave. That's kind of like the internet, the attention span on the internet is super, super short. So, I understand it's disappointing, but that's just how it is. That's just how internet is. I think that's probably my main response to everything you've said in here in your video, almost everything. My response is, that's just how internet is. Like, I understand you're upset at people nerd-raging and being upset, but it's kind of unrealistic to have this notion. And I do respect this notion. You have this notion that people should wait until they get all the information and process that information, and then afterwards, share their opinions and thoughts. I respect that notion. That's how we can have really rational and intelligent and fully informative discourses and debates. And that's how we do it, by processing information that way, thinking things through, and then talking, and then sharing our opinions. But that's not how the internet works. And honestly, I wouldn't, you know, in some ways, that sounds cool, but in some ways, I don't want the internet to work that way. It's just not as fun that way, and people realize it. Internet is all about generating clicks, generating views, and people behind internet content knows that, and they always manipulate it for that purpose, to generate views and to generate clicks. And a lot of that right now is because there is no actual news to be involved in. A lot of that is based on rumors. You know, people get a rumor and it's just boom, you know, a big bang of content from there about, you know, about that. People rage, people rant, people share their opinions and thoughts based on those rumors and speculations. I don't see that as a wrong thing. That's just how internet works. And it's actually entertaining to watch for me. I don't know, maybe some people who are nerve-raging will have heart problems later in life because they're so angry all the time. But as someone who doesn't really get angry like that, I like watching it. I like watching the content. You know, and a lot of people that do the rants and are nerve-raging or whatever, I feel like they actually bring up a lot of valid points in the process. And so, while I respect that you're telling people to calm their tits or chill their tits, I respect the notion, but I don't really think it's a pragmatic or a realistic one to expect out of the internet culture. That's pretty much what I have to say on you being upset that the internet is so angry. But on a deeper level, on this particular issue about Xbox One and Microsoft, I actually personally think that all this rage is actually justified. And you agree with me actually that Microsoft just hasn't been doing really well with this public relations strategy regarding Xbox One. The way they've been revealing information piecemeal has been very disastrous. It's been really dumb, stupid, and just, this is not how you do. This is not how you share your information about your next generation console. This just isn't. I mean, there's two ways to go about it that is very professional. One way, and this is how everyone usually does it, is to keep your mouth shut. Don't say anything, you right? And everything that people are basing off of their speculation is on based on rumors, not what the actual company has said. That's usually how it goes. You know, Sony, they're keeping their mouths shut right now about PlayStation 4. They did their reveal, and after that, they didn't say nothing. They're just like, okay, wait till E3. That's one way to go about it. So either way, one way is to just keep your mouth shut and tell people to wait, or the second way is to actually reveal information from an official representative. These two methods are really the professional way of revealing information about a new console, and Microsoft hasn't been doing either. It's been a mismatch of both. It's been really frustrating to see how Microsoft has been revealing information. It's why there's so much confusion and so much controversy and so much rumors, because after Xbox One reveal press conference, there are all these Microsoft representatives who are answering these questions. Phil Harrison is saying one thing about used games. Microsoft support Twitter feed is saying one thing. Aaron Greenberg is saying one thing. And if everything they said matched up with one consistent fact or information, that would have been great. You know, that would have been, you know, a company revealing information about its plans. But it wasn't. What Phil Harrison was saying, what Microsoft support Twitter feed was saying, what Aaron Greenberg was saying, what Larry Bird, you know, Major Nelson was saying, different information, conflicting information. One is saying, no, there will be no fees on used games. One is saying, yeah, you know, we're gonna have a policy on used games that's gonna be really different. Like, what the heck is going on, you know? So, for example, this is a complete contrast to right now, Sony. And Nintendo is doing, I think Nintendo is probably doing the smartest thing right now. It's doing this Nintendo Direct, where it is actually company saying out, this is our company's information stream, and this is the information that we're going to deliver you right now. And this is official. This is what Nintendo is doing. This is what Nintendo is planning to do. These games are coming. Boom! One video. Next week, another video. This is awesome. That's one way to do it. And then there's Sony, who's just like, not gonna tell you nothing. Nope, not gonna tell you anything. So there was a response, actually. There was a Twitter campaign on PlayStation 4 after Jeff Keighley was just like, there is speculation that, you know, PlayStation 4 is also going to have a policy that goes against used games. And then the Twitter feed was alight with anger, you know? And there was this whole campaign that a lot of people started tweeting to Sony employees and to Sony. And Sony responded. And a lot of people, well, not Sony in general, but people who work at Sony, tweeted back like, look, thanks guys for your concern. We understand your concern. And this is something that we're going to address in E3. So pretty much, like, we're not going to tell you anything, but we appreciate your concern. But just wait till E3. That's what Sony has done. Microsoft has not done that. Microsoft has just been like, you ask a good question, here's my answer. And that answer is in complete contrast with something else some other Microsoft employee has given. So that's why there's all these speculations and rage. I think it totally makes sense, just based on how Microsoft has revealed this information. And I still don't know anything about what Xbox One is going to be like. It's weird. Like, if you're going to give information, give information that is, you know, concrete, that is consistent, whatever. If you're not going to give information, don't give it. Just tell us to wait and keep your mouth shut. You know? that's part of the deal. The other thing is, I think people are upset at Microsoft, not only because, you know, Blunty, you talk about how cell phones, right? Now almost every cell phone has a camera now, and that's expected. Cell phones nowadays aren't just about talking on the phone and calling people. And you're like, well, why are people upset that, you know, Xbox One is going to add in a new functionality? Why are people upset? I think the reason is not only because of the functionality. I mean, if it's going to add functionality, that's okay, whatever. But so much of the, it's a shift in philosophy, you know. And philosophy for what? For features that most people outside of America don't even care about. You said it yourself in your first video about Xbox One. You live in Australia. All those features, you know, being able to switch the cable box features, being able to watch ESPN that way, or get minute-to-minute football fantasy stats as you're playing a video game. Do you care as an Australian? And do you really think you're going to get any of those features on launch in Australia? No. And the rest of the world is not going to be either. This is a totally, this reveal was totally an American-centric, US-centric conference. And people all over the world are watching this. So yeah, I understand why they're nerd raging. Because that was crap. That's not how you reveal a console. You reveal a console with the global market in mind. You're a global company now. Microsoft is a global company now. I don't know why they just did that. You know, this is like, this is what we're focusing on. And features that maybe will be a big sell in America, depending on how they do their pricing models. I listened to Michael Pachter on this, but I really agree with Michael Pachter on how Microsoft is going to set their pricing models. And if Microsoft does that, this will be a huge success in America. But honestly, beyond, like, is that success? Will that success be justified? And that's the problem that people are having. I don't think so. You know, these are features that I personally don't care about. Gamers don't care about. If it's a new functionality or new feature that enhances the entertainment experience, go for it, you know. But like, it really doesn't add too much. It's a little bit convenient. But do you remember, what was it? Don Matrick, I think, was the one person who kind of commented about why Xbox One will be so awesome. He was talking about, like, well, you know, I like to play video games while I'm watching TV, while I'm listening to music, while I'm talking with my friends. Who plays video games that way? What the that's ridiculous. You know, playing video game while watching a movie, while talking to friends, while listening to music is what Xbox One allows you to do. But seriously, how many people are interested in playing a video game that way, or watching a movie that way, or listening to music that way, or talking to friends that way? I think there's a parody of this concept, but this is the philosophy of Xbox One, that your box is going to replace every single medium, and that's why it's called one and all. But it's not really. Xbox One, at the end of the day, is still going to be another device you hook up to a TV along with many other devices. It's not the name Xbox One is a wrong name for it, simply because I know the intention, but that's not what's going to end up happening. People are going to have they're still going to have a lot of other devices hooked up to their TV, and judging by the size of this thing, it's a huge device. I'm almost worried how big PlayStation 4 is going to be. But yeah, that's my response to you, Blunty. I respect your notion. I respect you telling people to calm the fuck down and wait till you get all the information. But, you know, waiting is a boring game. And the internet doesn't like to be bored. The internet culture likes to respond immediately. And there's really no fighting against that. We like to speculate. Internet likes to speculate. Internet likes to rant. And most importantly, people like to watch that. I like to watch people rant about, you know, about rumors and such. It's just how internet works. And it's just how we nerd rage and stuff. So I don't know. Last thing I want to say is you don't want to be associated with gamers who are doing this. As if gamers have a league to join? I don't know. It's not like we have a reputation to uphold as a gamer. It's a weird label, I think. You know, we don't say a person reading a book, we don't say he's a reader. or you know, he doesn't have that association. I think once gaming is actually accepted as a mainstream concept, like the term gamer will no longer have a much big meaning anymore, simply because it's one of the things that people do. People read books, people watch movies. We don't say people are movie watchers, and you're like, oh my god, I don't want to be associated with that movie watcher because he's totally just upset about how the new Twilight movie sucked, and or new Twilight movie will suck. Oh my god, he's nerd raging. Don't call me a movie watcher anymore because I don't want to be associated with him. Yeah, doesn't work with movies. Right now, gaming is still at the stage where it's not accepted. Not fully accepted, it's becoming to be accepted, but I think we're still at like adolescent stage, gaming wise. So that's an interesting notion that we bring up. Like, I don't want to be called a gamer anymore because I don't want to be associated with these nerd raging fanboys. Okay, but like that's a weird thing to say. So anyway, this has been my long video response to you. I enjoy your videos, so keep making them, Blunty, and yeah, cheers.